Hey! Welcome to another Season 50 League match, and it's my first with. Oh, it's my first with a new client. So let's see how this works. Okay, what do we have? We have plus buy, draw, cathedral trashing. That's very important. It makes torture and familiar quite a bit less interesting. Mean, the actual payload isn't all that exciting. It's only treasury. But I think that's enough. See, I think we do Potion Cathedral rather than Cathedral Silver or something. Torture seems kind of garbage. Resign, rewind, undo one, Kingdom Spectators, full screen. Options. Show chat log, preferred background. Ooh. Isn't workshop kind of garbage? Probably take a silver here. Rather than a candlestick? No, maybe it's the candlestick. No, one silver has to be correct, right? I think so. They haven't gone for potion. Huh, maybe I should have taken candlestick. Guess I kind of just want to buy pool. But one silver shouldn't be bad. Yeah, you can keep that on top. Okay, let's get a candlestick now then. I think I want slightly faster. Innovation doesn't look very impressive. Raider is not impressive at all. What are they getting here? Do I just take two candlestick makers? No, I don't think so. I don't think one extra is worth the coffer. Yeah, the animations is definitely something to get used to. Discard, discard. God damn it. This is taking forever. Wait, there's the trash. Test corn. Okay. It's your turn. Raider looks like utter garbage. It sure is taking forever for me to get going. Yes, discard it. Come on! Yes, thank you. I mean, I suppose I want it. I want to let you have Devil's Workshops. Sure. So I can buy a pool, and I can buy another candlestick maker if I want. I think I do. But I kind of really want to get treasuries. They should just start provincing. Yeah. Let's try no. This kind of sucks, but okay, this is good. So 7. I mean, do I even need another pool here? Or that just a treasury candlestick maker? Do I take a gold? I think I do treasury candlestick maker. And I kind of want to never top deck the treasury. It's a bit funny. There's a pool down here. You can keep that. Oh, but I'm drawing it. Whoops. This is still 7. Yeah, I'm like barely adding payload. Yeah, but for 7 I can add 2 payload or I can add 3 payload. Candlestick makers are better payload than treasuries though. Maybe I just do pool double candlestick maker. But we trashed the candlestick maker. Wait, that also only added 2. Do they even have any coppers left? I think I might add coppers to my deck. Because I'm overdrawing by a shit ton. This is 9. Gold candlestick maker. I don't know if I can add 2 coppers. I think I can. I'm not sure. No, I probably can. Treasury is so bad. It's so expensive. Yeah, they have 3 provinces already. I should have them top deck them. Okay. That was easy. Yeah, so I can buy a province here. 13. Or I can buy double gold. I mean, is that better? In the treasury? Kind of. Yeah, I'm not sure what I'm doing here. It feels like I haven't played this correctly. These treasuries are so bad. Did I finally get punished? Looks like I did. So give me, well, I can't buy pool there. So yeah, so maybe I should have bought gold treasury pool there instead. Because like I need to be able to hold green, especially if I want to catch up. Yeah, now I have like 3 golds, Two coppers potion. Wait, I can only exactly draw a deck. Yeah, I need the treasury to be hands to for the pool to be hand size increasing. So I can't in fact draw a deck this turn. What do we do while waiting? They trash a province? Wow. Okay, we got a pull. Toss that. Think we toss that. Okay, never mind. We want another copper? I don't think so. No, but next time I do turn, I'm drawing. Think it's fine. Yeah, we're losing the candlestick here. This should be like pool province or something. It can be double province pooled. So this is 20. I need to get used to the province change, the coffers change. Wait, if I double and they take a province. 24, I'm at 12. Then I need to promise double duchy. That seems hard. So maybe I do promise duchy pool. Can I add a copper? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 stop cards. I'm not sure I can. Maybe. Well, I get the treasure copper here. That's nice. It's kind of weird that I don't have a terminal. Should I have a tax man? Should probably have gotten a tax man, right? Torture is bad. Rabble doesn't do anything. Should we get a familiar? No. No, not really. Raider could do something. Could make them discard their golds. Since they don't have any pools. It's too late. But yeah, say that they province now, then they're 24. Then I need double province duchy estate. I can maybe do that? It's hard. Trash of gold. Oh, but did they get a province? I mean, this is clearly bad. Oh no, now they have a raider incoming. Toss that. Toss that. Guess we can find you a green card. Yes. I think I need more treasuries to keep drawing. Wait, I have 22. 6, 12. I can get a tie. It's pretty bad. Oh. Is a tie good enough? They have a raider incoming. If they take a province, they're up to 30. Yeah, the only question is, can they province? Three, six, seven. They have three golds in deck. One of them is in those top three. Two of them are. Wait, they played two golds and then they drew without shuffling. And then I looked through their deck, saw one of the golds. Okay, so if these two bottom cards are both golds, then they don't have golds in hand. But I think they do have a gold in hand. In which case, I think I should take the tie. Or is, oh, 6, 7, 8, 13, 14. Gardens is worth 2. So it doesn't help. Yeah.
Yeah, I should have used my pools to scout their deck. Now let's see, what do we have? University, urchin trashy, village, research, shepherd, stables, merchant guild, grove. Wall. So we've got plus buy, we've got actions, we got draw, we got trashing. I mean, I presume we trash with the urchins. Rather than research, that's much better, isn't it? I think we do double urchin open and then get a potion again, then get a uni. Yeah, urchin. This is good. Almost. Do I wanna buy a silver? No, I don't want silvers in this deck. Well, stables wants some treasures. But do we even draw with stables? Not sure. Village here is garbage. I mean, it's really likely that. I think we take an urchin. So we take double merc. So we trash down super fast and get uni and then fill the deck. Okay, they didn't collide. How did they not collide? No, wait. Ah, never mind. They're play two. Is that even good? I guess it's good for the moment. Is this last card copper? It is, so let's get the potion. Okay, this is a blessed. don't need three. Although maybe I don't need the. No, but urchins are kind of good. Or at least they're not stop cards. I'm thinking usually want to keep one urchin to do the attack, but here we got Margraves. So let's toss the copper. Okay, they finally got their Merc. They're quite behind on trashing. Well, not that behind. No, they're blue. Depends on if they find it. Oh, they got the Mercenary Direct. Oh, okay, they're not behind at all. Lucky. No, they're still slightly behind. I need to find my uni somehow in these 10 cards with this urchin. Yeah, so I want to find the uni with urchin, or I don't want to find it with the Merc. Yeah, toss the urchin then, I guess. Okay, that's good. Stables? Oh, damn it. Let's buy silver, I guess. There's a Merc down here. We want to find it. Oh, that's good. Okay, let's get another uni. Uni for ugh. Stables? Or do I take a blessed? I think I take a stables. That's good. I only have a single blessed. But I have two unis. I think Margrave is good. Let's get another silver. Please don't make me discard down to three. You probably will, right? Because you didn't last turn. So do I trash or do I buy a uni? I probably trash, right? Oh, you don't want to trash the pasture with Whale Worm. Yeah. Wait, have they? Oh, that's kind of you. That's very kind of you. think I trashed the urchin and the merc. Yeah, that was correct. Do I want to keep the potion or the silver? Probably the potion, yeah. Uni 4. Don't have a lot of treasures. I think 2 Margraves are fine. Maybe not. I'm not sure. Yeah, now we take Blessed and Margrave, I think. Wait, is this a good shuffle? I think it is. Nah, it's better to have it start your turn. Blessed and Sicken Margrave. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 potion. So that's uni silver. Some point we're gonna go into merchant guilds. This is a very good wind. Probably toss a uni next. I think we need more blessed. It's a bit weird that it says that it has the best village icon for set aside. It feels like it should be like the wind's gift or the boon. How are piles looking? They're fine. Toss a uni now. How many treasures do I have in my deck? Okay, there's 2 coppers and a pasture down there. So I can probably toss these, I think. This is very hard to figure out what makes me least likely to dud. It's uni for a blessed here. I think I'll take that at the start of my next turn, because that's pretty good dead prediction. That means I can toss in a couple extra Margraves, I think. Don't know if I want to keep my pasture or not. Silver potion, and I've played. There's three treasures down there. Yeah, I just need to draw the three treasures, and I'm drawing those, no problem. I think I want the Merchant Guild. And I think I want a. Wait, there's four cards down there I want to draw. Potion, Silver, Pasture, Merchant Guild. It's four cards. These two draws four cards. Okay, I'm not dotting next turn. Oh no, this no I'm not. Yeah, that. Oh wait, what? There's extra cards in here. I didn't count on having. Frick. Oh, I forgot I had that last turn or something, right? Yeah, there's way more cards down here than I thought it was. Okay, I need more draw then. Wait, did I have a dud last turn? No. Why is there. Oh no, I had to discard. Last card is a potion. Oh, this is so bad. No, but wait, I have. Yeah, this is probably fine. No, I don't want to discard any of this. Let's put the Margrave on top, I guess. I'm not really tracking my deck. And piles are slowly chipping away. It's not that bad. I need more draw, right? Yeah, I do. Let's get another stables. Oh, that was dumb. Okay, whatever. I need, should get Margraves because I have spare actions. Take a Margrave. Now I'm not guaranteed to draw it. So I should gain extra things. Let's get another merchant guild and let's get another Margrave, something like that. Stables of silver. Stables the pasture. Oh, I'm not tracking my deck at all. This is so bad. Wow. Wow. Okay, so I can worm thrice if I want. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8. Or I can take province uni. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Because, like, I need a province. And I kind of want the game to last a bit longer. Yeah, I had one more stables than I thought I had. Something. Yeah, I'm not tracking my deck. Whatever. Province uni. Toss Merc Silver here. Or Merc Uni. So I have still I have 5 treasures in deck, now 4 stables. I think I have all the stables. 1, 2, 3, 4, yeah. But I think I shouldn't toss the silver. Well, or I can just not toss. Let's toss the potion. At some point we're gonna s possibly start trashing universities. But I think we're gonna gain a shit ton of merchant guilds here. Oh, I probably wanna merc the potion. Yeah, I don't want more unis. Yeah. Okay, so I shouldn't have discarded it. But we shouldn't have gained the uni last turn either. Margrave is such an obnoxious card. Obnoxious card, obnoxious card. Margrave is such an obnoxious card. Dup 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 dome. So how many points is the pasture? It's gonna be 2, 3 points for me. So stables. Toss a silver. So I've tossed 2 treasures. I mean, so we can draw them all up. And then we can think. So I can definitely end the game, but can I do it winningly? Don't think I have enough money for that. Eight. I think I can double. Wait, if I can double and trash a couple cards, then I'm golden. So to double, I need 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So I need two more money. So I can get that from merchant guilds. No, but then I need another more, then I need more points. Four, five, six. So I can play everything. But not if I gain more stuff. I mean, I can gain Blessed Merchant Guild if I want. And then double. Trashing Unicopper. That's 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 16. Perfect. Wait, I want to trash. Fuck. 4, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Wait, how many cards do I have in exile? 2. No. Four, five, six. Merc with trash uni potion. We play blessed. Where did it come from? Play merchant guild. 7, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Well, that's more than I thought it was. Anyway, double province. That's not even the points lead. Can they take three urchins is the question. Maybe I opened up a horrible loss here. Yeah, I think that was kind of bad. I'm playing this awfully. No, I don't think I was close to win. Yeah, no, we're not trashing. Oh, thank God. No! I think we trashed the mercs. Like, they're just too money. The merchant guilds. I can get more if I want to. Holy shit! What?! Is this draw? Oh my God, please resign. Why? I had an awful dud. I'm not gonna tell them. I'm not gonna tell them. I'll let them know afterwards. Maybe I could take the points lead. Like, maybe I had the win regardless, but like, wow. Ah, I haven't learned what the kingdom button is. Well, tack done certainly doesn't work together. Wait, what's going on here? Do you play with tack? No, I don't think so. Because you want to play with both treasures and dens. So definitely not. I think you want the Devil's Workshop at some point. Do we open push peasant silver, peasant race? Potion isn't crazy. Like the copper. The copper trashing is really bad. No, we'll get there. No, we don't want to trash the coppers because we want to get them in Apu. Ooh, so is it potion or raise? Keep makes a good... Oh, we have already bought the four card hand, so... No matter. Well, Lurker is strong. We get border villages with it. We probably want several peasants. taking Watchmen here isn't crazy, although it's not. No, I think you need teacher. Kinda ASAP. Yeah, those cards are so bad. Let's take a Night Watchman. Now let's take a potion. I'm not sure where we're putting tokens on. It's on Border Village and Apo. That's probably it. Race or Lurker? Oh, we're not playing this Night Watchman. Where are we? Four Coppers Estate Potion. No, we don't. We also have Raise on top. So we want to keep that. I mean, Lurker is too good. We can't skip it. This sucks. This sucks. I haven't trashed a single estate. They haven't either, so. I want another peasant. Oh, I need everything. I think I gotta pop the race. Fugitive. This is good. They haven't taken a border village. They haven't taken a lurker, so. Let's trash that from the supply. Buy an upper, play a Night Watchman. Toss these five garbage cards. Do we take peasant or race? Or lurker? Probably lurker. Didn't be so good. Feels like I'm playing this horribly. Maybe not. Well, it's not gonna be any disciple targets down here. I think you needed more lurkers earlier. Like lurker in game Border Village Den is like crazy, right? That's much better than going potion. Or Night Watchman. What's even in there to disciple? Barely anything. A lurker, I think. I really need a disciple after I get my... But I need to get my draw going as well. Den doesn't play well with Apo. Yeah, at least we can disciple a lurker here, get another border village and a den. And I get my teacher online very early. But I don't have like I don't have any cards in my deck to disciple, or and I don't have any cards in my deck to use the teacher token. I think we're starting by putting plus card on border village at least. I think it's time to buy a peasant now. Toss, probably toss the potion too. Oh, this shuffle doesn't have disciple in it, but it does have two. Yeah, it's probably worth it. So like, do I have a race? I don't know if I do. Did I buy a race at some point? I don't think I bought a race. No, I don't have any races. But I have lurkers. I have plenty lurkers, so they can easily pick up races. Which makes them half a cantrip. No, they're gonna gain border villages. Definitely toss a copper so the Apo can find it. Yeah, sequencing what to buy here is super hard, I think. Because, like, you want a shit ton of stuff. Putting a race into this shuffle is very tempting. But so is getting border villages. Because like, there's three estates in here. And there are no... Yeah, let's take a race. This is so awful. Let's draw all of those cards and nothing else. And then get Border Village, and a den, play a peasant, buy Apo. Do I need more lurkers? Peasants aren't gonna last. The game is gonna end soon. Not even sure that one is gonna get anywhere. Finally get the trash estate. Maybe I shouldn't have raised the race back when I did it early on. Trash the copper. Did it to put a fugitive into my hand. Two coppers, lurker potion race. Okay, no, that's a garbage hand. Wow. I think... I don't know. This feels so slow. I'm not sure if I should put plus card on Lurker or Border Village. Oh, that's good. Yeah, but this keep. I don't know what's good. I don't know what's good. Is teaching him worth it? You get to put plus card on something, but. I suspect the game's gonna be too slow for that. I don't know. This board is tricky. Oh. Wow. What? There's a den of sin in the trash? Oh, but I can't gain it. I think we'll take Border Village then. I think we're gonna gain a race. Buy a lurker. How many lurkers do I have? have four. I think I should buy the lurker and then put plus. Plus card on it. Those are good cards. Although there's not as many races down here. So yeah, I'm gonna put plus card on Lurker. And then I'm gonna pile this possibly on this turn. Okay, they tied me on potion. I don't think Night Watchman is worth it in peasant games. Should have just been a race. Like, it's much better in page games because their rushing champion is much more of a thing. But it really isn't in peasant games. Like, I should have just accepted that I'm missing a turn. They're trashing Den of Sins! I'm so confused. Why would you ever do that? That's like the best card on the board. What am I tossing? Border Village, I think. I don't have any actions in my deck. No terminal actions, I mean. Yeah, you're doing all this work to get an imp, but an imp and a Den of Sin is almost as good. Well, okay, no. Den of Sin is half an imp. But like, don't trash your Den of Sins, my friend! Wow! Yes, sure. So what are we lurking? Can we end it this turn? Wait, how did they? Oh, they bought a silver. Oh no, I can't trash the potion. Do I raise the border village? Or do I raise the race? Yeah, so I don't think I'm piling now, but I am soon. Let's take the Night Watchman and trash it. It's in the trash. Oh, I didn't see I drew a lurker. That was bad. It's because this card is on top. Damn it. I don't have any plus buy. So I guess we're buying a province. Or are we buying a gold? Does it matter much? Yes. I don't know. Yeah, let's exchange. Well, I kind of got through my deck. Did I have zero? No, wait. Oh, the Innocent don't show up in the log when you play them. Wait, then. No, it says plays a Den of Sin. Did I not play in Den of Sins here? How few dens do I have? I don't know. Imps are good. It moves back? That's frustrating. I have no clue if a longer game is good for me or not. Okay, took forever. Wait, do they have a win? Wait, how are they gonna get so much points? I can probably buy province. Promise potion. Probably the easiest way. Okay, if it's a pile out, I'm fine. Okay, they take a potion. But can they end now? No. They buy a duchy. So. Oh, if you raise border village and lurk it back. Ah, shoot, I should have done that. Is it too late now? I mean, there gotta be a lurker room with those, one of these six cars, right? I have a shit ton of them. Yeah. Okay, this sure still isn't a win. So they've taken an extra potion. Silver or duchy better? I think silver is better. Third game. Nah, I don't want to stress them out at the end of a game. I'll say it for the next game. because they certainly are a bit slow. Do they have a soldier? They do. I'll go fix food. So what should you actually do on this board? Keep disciples. Like, disciple board a village to gain dens is extremely strong. But the problem is that you don't need the actions from the border village. So if you go for that, you try to get a plus card token on border village. Okay, this feels like it should win. I need to empty piles and get a silver. Yeah, that's trivial, isn't it? Lurk three races. Buy silver. That works, right? We have two silvers each. Can I get a gold? I can get a lot of things. Can just get a duchy. Don't need to count, keep at all. Oh, what's going on here? Wait. Okay, so you want a sanctuary to get rid of coppers and for plus buy. This is just a ridiculously strong kingdom. Silver dungeon, I'm pretty sure. Not sure if we get sanctuary or recruiter first. Probably recruiter. Dungeon or merchant? It's gonna be five in next hand, right? It's not guaranteed. I think I like the second dungeon. Merchant here. I like the dungeon less when it misses. Oh, so bad, not though at five. So I'm up 2.5, 7.5. Pretty decent. This start is not great, but it's a good kingdom. Now I think you should get a sanctuary. Second recruiter I don't like. I don't hit five. Main dungeon isn't that good at hitting five, but this is so bad. This should be at least. Do you even need the recruiter? I guess you don't mind the villagers with the paddock. But I almost want to get a sanct now. Instead of the recruiter, and get started on peddlers. Because I have four action cards. Yeah, let's get a sanctuary. Do I? Yeah, I think I do. I mean, all draws can't be that bad. Yeah, no, this should be good. If I just draw a little bit less awful. So, question now is, do I exile states or coppers? I think I exile estates. And get a second sanctuary and a peddler. Wait, how does this work? I should discard like this. Because I'm likely to draw an estate. Ah, my silver! Should I have gotten a second silver at some point? Should we get the second silver now? Should I get a menagerie? Nah, let's just get an extra peddler. Ah, I probably should have gotten a second silver. I really should have. I thought with a pair of dungeons that I should, would be able to pair them up. But it really haven't worked like that. Yeah, sanctuary for sure. How likely is Silver Dungeon to hit 5? It's quite a bit worse than Silver Moat. Peddler or ride? Peddler, I think. It is starting to feel kind of silly, though. This is like, sure, I didn't get a second silver, but. They've lined up exactly once, I think. Wait, have they never lined up? I'm not seeing a single time. Well, they maybe lined up, but I couldn't use the money. I should probably get paddocks now. Instead of a third sanctuary. If I can afford five. So that's all my estates. What's the ordering here? Don't know. It's a lot of money. Paddock. Peddler. Peddler? Five cards in exile, so five copies left in deck. Which means I have like six stop cards. No, the dungeon makes counting hard. Think I'm ahead. Not sure. Or I think I've caught up at least. But they have two paddocks on me. Yeah, I don't have the hand size to play sanctuaries, exiling bad cards, and playing dungeons, discard bad cards. Like, both of those are net. Both of those are minus one hand size. Oh, but I don't need to end my turn with terminal cards in hand. Oh, they've trashed Recruiter. This is a bit awkward for them. So I'm not gonna empty peddlers for them. Do I want to exile this? Wait, what are those three cards? It's merchant, silver. Possibly a peddler. I don't think I should exile. Six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Yeah, don't exile. Oh, but I don't want to play this merchant. No, actually, I can. Top taking coppers is actually good with the dungeon. Sure, yeah. How many horses do they have? They have 8 horses. Okay, they can recruit horses to activate the paddocks. That's not a problem. But I can't take... Well, I can take one paddock extra. I mean, double paddock peddler is not great. I think I want another buy. Because, like, I want to click ride and merchant and peddler and certain pile up and stuff. I feel behind. Their paddocks are so good. Yeah, so the recruiter lets you buy paddocks. Yeah, the recruiter lets you buy paddocks and the sanctuary lets you buy peddler. I hope this is awkward for them. They played 1, 2, 3, 4 horses. They've gained 6 horses and trashed 1. So they're net plus 1 horse. But okay. I think they're gonna click peddler now. I'm not sure. Like, if they don't click peddler here, I'm sure as hell not buying it. In that case, I think I want to keep exiling. But I'm not entirely sure. Oh, if I buy the paddocks, I activate the paddocks. And then they're up two paddocks on me. This is my last copper. Yeah, whatever. Wait. 15. This is a weird spot. But they only have three buys. Like, should I activate or should I not? I can buy Paddock Paddock Peddler. And whatever, merchant, duchy. Oh, then I don't threaten the pile out, you know, and then my upside is 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. They have two paddocks on me, but I have a lot of peddlers on them. I think that's better. But I'm not sure. If I don't take the activate the paddocks, they have to recruit a paddock, but then they're fine. Yeah. Only question now is, do I want a sanctuary or a merchant or a duchy? Will a merchant pay off until the game is over? Before the game is over? I think it may. But yeah, so I'm not threatening the pilot right now, but I don't think that matters because they're definitely scoring now because there's not much more to build. So they are the first to score. Can they do more than double? Wait, no, I mean, can they double is the question. They have 6 paddocks. Okay, that's 6 paddocks is 12, silver is 14, merchant is 15. Okay, so they can double, but I think I can do more than double. I had 15, but then I added 8, so I think I have 23. Yeah, I don't know if the dungeon is good anymore. Yeah, you can double, but you can't double and build. But I can. And I'm ahead in VP. Phew! I feel good now, I think. I hope I'm going to draw a stop card here. Because drawing all these paddocks is not gonna be that easy. I have two coppers, silver, dungeon, and 4 paddocks. Well, the dungeon doesn't really count. But yeah, I think I'm gonna have to gain and play horses to get all paddocks in play. Oh! Gets plus $1 merchant. Wow! Wait, what? Oh, never mind. Wait, I can search for parentheses merchant. First time somebody got money from a merchant was me on turn 10. And I bought the merchant on turn 4. So yeah, turn 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, here we go. Wow. Wait, I should have threaten the pileout? Fuck. Oh, now I need to count. They had 18. Now they're up to 24. So they can triple. I think I need to keep the dungeon to get through the paddocks. I think we can toss the merchant. No, let's toss the sanctuary. Oh, I forgot I had horses in my deck. Well, we're playing that then. So yeah, paddock. So these are peddler, paddock. Sanctuary. There's no reason to discard paddocks over the other stuff. I think I should put in a lot of horses now. There's two, there's three stop cards down there. How does this work? Let's see. No, there's four. I discarded four cards with a dungeon. One of them is a sanctuary. There's three stop cards I need to draw, which means I need at least three horses. No, because I have extra peddlers. Now if I play peddler and sanctuary and those... I think I'm gonna play one extra that I don't need to play. Just to make it more likely to find horses. Oh my god, no, no, holy fucking poop. Okay, well, that's that. That's awful. That's so awful. It's six horses in those eight. Okay. So this is 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. Twenty-three doesn't do anything. So I think it's promise, promise, duchy. An exile copper. Because now if they triple, they're up to... Twenty-one. Duchy doesn't really do anything. I think we're taking it anyway. Do I have more money in the deck? Can I quad? No, can I triple, I mean? Scars Copper Sanctuary. I should probably buy more gold, I think. Or I can get a grave robber. Let's take a gold. Grobber is probably stronger, but no, Grubber must be better, right? Yeah. Yeah, they can triple, but I can triple back. But I think they should triple. Oh, wait, they dudded. Wait, no, they didn't. Oh, I was like, they have 11 cards left in deck. But no, 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 they have top decked 11 horses. Can I punish them for not, well, oh no, I shouldn't necessarily do that. Okay, so I can top deck horses now and exile the dungeon. Is it GG? No, I don't have quad. And four buys can't end it. So if I take triple province, then I have 33. They can only hit 30 because they only have three buys. Yeah. Six, nine, 12 is 30. Yeah. Okay, what's going on here? No plus buy. And archive is the only thinning. So no plus pile makes Fool's Gold bad. No thinning makes City Quarter bad. Shantytown and Vagrant are kind of bad. Silk Road Nobles is almost a catch-up thing. I mean, we almost surely open Archive Silver, right? Is there a case for Seer? I mean, I guess there is, but I think Archive money is better than Seer money. Yeah. Shanty. I mean, I guess Shantytown is a lost city. If you only ever get one, it's good. I guess I'll follow. Want Archive, Gold, Silver, possibly a Baker. No, Archive over Baker. So yeah, Silver, Archive, or Gold, depending on what we hit. This is Silver. Archive or Gold? What do we want? Probably Archive. Yeah, I think take a copper and buy an Archive. Do we get another Archive here? That's a lot of Archives. Especially with all three of them in our deck at the same time. No, but three Archives sounds good. We don't really need the Baker for smoothing with Archives. So we take another Archive here. Could have pre-moved that Archive. And now we want to buy a Gold, I think. And then start greening. It's a bit unfortunate that these Archives are I think I take the copper. But I'm not sure. No, I think I do. It's not that easy to hit six again. Vizier looks awful. So yeah, now we take gold, copper, buy another gold, and then we're off to the races, right? That's an estate, that's a copper, that's a copper. So we're auto taking all of those. And these are a crap load of estates, so you can primo the shanty town. Presume you get used to the pre-move, but at the moment it feels so cool when you get to use it. Now do I need to? Oh, damn it. How are they thinking that they can? Man, so bad. So sad I don't get an archive in this hand. Okay, I'm not hitting province here. This should... I don't know if it should, this should be duchy from them. Yeah, they got a full gold and a seer, and I have two golds. That's the difference. Oh, thank God. They bought a full gold. That sounds awful. I'm gonna buy a duchy. Now let's see, there's no silver down here. But there is a gold, and I think I'm guaranteed to find it. Yes. Now I need to take the archive. Oh, you can do multiple pre-moves. This looks so cool. No, it didn't work. Oh, I can't pre-move this. Well, I'm taking a duchy, I guess. Yeah, so now I would like to pre-move and buy a province. No, I can't. It doesn't do it. Ja. Well, we take this silver, I suppose. Yeah, we even afford the province. Nice! Post game. Click ready. Okay, we got shelters. Okay, what do we have here? No actions at all. Yeah. Absolutely no actions. And the terminals are kind of trash. Copper trashing is bad. What are we doing? I think we open Vampire, because we don't mind picking up. Apprentice Vamp isn't draw, really. Minting gold that you apprentice, that's something. Oh, never mind. Teamog is awful. Teamog is awful with shelters. Do you bother with a necropolis? No, probably not. But we buy a state here, of course. On the four, do we take a nomad camp? Do we take a nomad camp or a silver? I don't know if I want the nomad camp. Probably not. Two. Do I want the apprentice? Since the bat can trash. The bad cards. Do I just want to gain a silver? Maybe I should have opened mint, actually. Open mint state, mint copper. Buy silver. Mint the silver. I don't really have a way to get rid of the apprentice then. Now I don't want to get the apprentice. I think I should get it still, though. Wow, that's mean. Holy shit. So do I take apprentice or silver? Think I take the apprentice. I'm not sure. Buy a silver here. We don't want to play the Necropolis. Does that stop the autoplay? Buy gold. Easy. Well, maybe not. Trash both. Trash estate here. Withdraw. Do I have one or two silvers? Think I only have one. Well, before the last one I bought. So these are two coppers. So maybe that's the mint. If it's two coppers, I want to get mint. If it's... Yeah, let's get a mint. I know I have a million trashing cards, but I can get a ton of mints here. Tons of silver here. Mint silver, vamp silver. Wait, I need to figure out what these cards are. It's silver, copper, right? Oh, this sucks. I think it's this. Yeah, get two silvers. I think I apprentice a silver now. That should get me a gold. This should be vampire, silver, silver, copper. Is Ritual Golden Deck a thing? It kind of is, isn't it? Do I want the spare silver? Yeah, I think I do, because I kind of want to apprentice it. And then I vamp for. So, like, buying ritual every turn gets me six. If my hand is mint, gold, Apprentice curse. Nah, I can almost do it, but not really. I think I take an apprentice and trash the vampire. Or I could take a T-Mog, turn a vampire into a gold, turn the apprentice into a gold. Yeah, I think I like a T-Mog. Probably just province here. This is a sad hand. Wow. I think I apprentice the bat. Getting rid of these coppers is gonna be messy. Kind of like ritual here, I think. Or do I apprentice the T-Mog to trash two coppers with the bat? Gain another gain with it? And then gain the T-Mog? Yeah, I need to get rid of these coppers. Oh, and the ritual wants the bat, right? So I can have either province or ritual here. It's the ritual. I don't know if it's better or not, but I want to do it. Taking a province here must be correct, though. Oh no! Envy! Yes, the question here is, do I trash the curse? Do I trash the silver? Do I trash the gold even? How many golds do I have? Three. That's not enough to trash golds. I think trashing the silver is decent. I think I want to trash the silver. Nice. And now, do I ritual the gold or do I buy a province? I don't know. Let's do it like this and gain an apprentice. I think I'm buying promises just to get the game to end. I have no clue what they are doing though. But they're building a good deck. They maybe are. What are they doing on their turns? They have a lot of vampires. It's like Vampire Apprentice isn't draw. Mint Apprentice is draw, but for what? Like, Mint Apprentice doesn't actually let you do more than single. I should have pre-moved that. Okay. But here, let's see, I do have a Teemog down. Do I want to mill a prov? Yeah, I think so. An apprentice, a gold. Is milling a pro? That's good. What else could I be doing? Two curses? Well, I have a bat, so that's fine. I think milling the prov is good enough. Alternative is keeping it to turn silver into a Teemog to do now. That doesn't do anything. All oh, right, I have another apprentice. Where are those three cards? province. There's coppers down there. I think it's a bad hand. So I think I want to get through it. Copper, silver, province, yeah. I think I just buy province. And trash curses with the bat. Rachel could be a thing if you could build slightly bigger. Like if there was a village on this board, no, then you still wouldn't do that, really. Oh, that's just a win. Where did all the provinces go? Yay! Yep, thanks for watching. Bye.